clubs, fuck partying, fuck trying to fit in and socialize, rub elbows with everybody so people can stop calling you weird. Why are you so antisocial? Because I'm trying to get it. Why are you out there practicing in the hot sun when ain't nobody else out there? Because I'm trying to get it. Why are you not clubbing? Like every time I text you and invite you to go do something fun and cool, you always studying. Because I'm trying to get it. Let me tell you something, homie. These women ain't going nowhere. These clubs, these parties, all this shit ain't going nowhere. The more weird you are is a reflection of how committed you are to focusing on your shit, molding and shaping and developing your ideas and your craft so that when it's time for you to make your rounds, you gonna fly.
Bitch, I'm a bitch.
Pop my shit. Yeah, I'm pop my shit. Nigga been having, you ain't got like this. Young nigga be hating, you ain't got like this. Pop my shit. Pop my shit. $2,000 on key. Yeah, I just flooded my collar, my ring.
See ya. It's your boy, Dre Pacito, and you are now Market Traffic. Yeah. Make sure y'all hit that like, share, subscribe, notification bell. Don't try to run now. You got to do that for me, man. Help your boy get in that algorithm. And y'all already know how we do what we do when we do what we do.
Wow.
The first two, do you.
Hey, man, check this out, right?
Hey, shout out to the female followers increasing. I'm trying to get money, too. Fed cut them rates. That's a buying opportunity. Let's get it. First two, do you? Market track. Shout out to the queens out there. All my market trappers. Let's get this money. First two, do you? Market trapping. Ain't no need of hating. Come get this money with me. First two, do you? Shout out Uncle Snoop, Ball Breathing, the OG Lil Duval, my brother Z the Alien. First two, do you? Fed cut them rates. Nah, not them feds. We ain't talking about them feds messing with Diddy. Talking about the Federal Reserve. Let's get that money.
To learn from people you disagree with. You gotta be able to learn from people you don't like. You gotta learn how to learn from people that don't like you. Because if the only people who can teach you something is people you got a good relationship with, you ain't gonna learn much because most people who like you won't teach you nothing.
For sure. And I give you another one. Some of the people you like still ain't gonna teach you.
Facts. That I know. I'm learning that on this side of the river. Right.
Your biggest fan, your biggest supporter, you don't even know.
Man, I had a motherfucker tell me I'm acting funny, like, I don't come around and shit no more. Like, I ain't acting funny. I'm just, man, real cautious about where I spend my time and how I spend my time now. Because to me, right now, time more important than money. Like, I can spend some money and make this shit big. Once I spend some time somewhere, fuck off some time, I can't get this shit back. Once your time gone, you can't get this shit back. Ain't that a motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Acting funny, it's just, you know, niggas on the same shit, doing the same shit they been doing. I ain't got time for this shit. I ain't got time to be wasting. My any extra time I got, if I ain't spending this shit with family, I'm spending this shit trying to figure out how to give me some more money and elevate. I still fuck with y'all. You want to spend some time with me? Get on the shit I'm on.
I don't know my mother, sister, brother.
There's no excuses in life.
Oh, so now everybody.
I'm just telling you, it's the real shit. Ain't no excuses. Listen, once you're a grown man, don't nobody give a fuck about none of that shit. Once you grown, nobody give a fuck about none of your past.
Oh, all
right. I'm telling you.
All right.
You ain't gotta listen to me. I mean, I don't know.
Wrong? I'm
wrong. Ain't nothing wrong with right. It ain't about wrong or right. It ain't got nothing wrong or right. Ain't even in it. I'm telling to you if I ain't give a fuck, I'm even telling you this shit.
Yeah.
The fuck I'm gonna be telling you this shit for? I mean, I'm just saying, motherfuckers don't care about excuses when you're a man. They don't give a fuck about none of that old shit. Your girl might care. That's it. No man ain't gonna care. You know what I'm saying? Real shit. You know what I'm saying?
All right,
sir. So I'm just, no, I'm just, it's real, like, don't, never, I told you, don't make excuses, don't nothing. Listen, be strong, be your own island. All
right.
You know what I mean? I ain't no different. All right. You know what I'm saying? I ain't telling you like I'm looking down, I'm just telling you how I do it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. You
know?
I understand.
Oh, what's up,
boy? Life is simple. It's either you're gonna put in the fucking work day in, day out, to get the life that you want, spiritually, mentally, physically, or financially, or you're gonna sit in the fucking bleachers and watch everybody else live their best life.
So how much your bills are right now? Like, when before I even want to make money, I want to tackle my bills. So if I have a debt of $5,500 a month, or what I'm gonna do is make me a job. You find me something that makes that money first. Before I go into my career, before I go into making money, I go work to pay that bill. Once I know this bill is done, outside of my job and paying my bill, and all my off time, after I get off work, mm-hmm. I don't go get a drink. I don't play the game. I don't lollygag. I use that time to study, invest in myself with more time of knowing things. And for three, I work towards what I want to be. Because where I'm at is not where I want to be. I see a lot of people complain about where they are because that's not where they want to be. But where you are is sustaining you to go to where you want to be.
At home. You tend to spend less money when you stay at home. You know, it's going to be friends. Like, well, what up, though? Let's go out. You know what I'm saying? Let's hit the bar. Drinks on me. You ain't got to spend nothing. No. You is going to have to spend something. Stay at home. Might be a man's birthday. Be like, all right, you know, bro, we going to party when the time right. But right now, I'm at the crib, man. You know, fuck the clubs and all that. It's going to be a time for all that. Stay your ass at home.
Nothing wrong with being broke, homie. Something wrong with someone being poor. Because poor is a mindset. Broke is just a temporary situation that you could fix. But being poor, that's a mind state
mm-hmm.
that most can't change. So that's why mama and them used to talk that Bible talk. Son, you got to renew your mind every day. You got to change the way you think. You got to be trying to think different. That shit didn't make no sense. But when you just start thinking logic and just take the biblical perspective out of it, every day you got to try to think different. And the conditions we in, yeah.
At two kind of people, well, multiple kind of people. Some people be discouraged by other people's success. And you have people like me who's motivated by other people's success. So you sit me down with somebody that got $1 billion, $10 billion, or $100 billion. You know, I believe in seeing is believing. Once I know you was able to get it, you got two arms, two legs, one brain just like me. Why I can't get it? I'm a hustler. I thrive. My adrenaline is always on building more. So I just look at any hustler, like, and I take my hats off to him and salute him. They're like, he hustling, one of those guys. And I'm one of those guys. So, you know, if there's anything I can learn and if there's anything I can see, I'm picking up.
Two different type of niggas out here. Failure can make a nigga back into a corner and get depressed, or I can turn a nigga up. As men, niggas gotta pick which one they gonna be. Cause you know, pressure hits some niggas and what they do, they fold.
They fold.
And then pressure hits some niggas and what they do, they get stronger.
Hey, if you one of them people that wait all week for the weekend cause you don't like your day job, you better not be taking Saturdays off. Come on now, you're doing yourself a disservice. Saturdays is meant to build the life you want outside of your obligations. What you doing? You better work on your side hustle. Work on your house, work on your yard, work on yourself, work on something. Don't just sit there waiting for Monday to come. You don't even like Mondays. You gotta take Saturdays as a challenge to separate you from the competition. Because successful people don't take weekends off until they are successful. Come on now, even then, they gonna use the weekend to sharpen their tools and hone in on the craft. Are you? I am. I don't take off either day. Shit, I'm working every day. I'ma get up, get over it, Get after it.
A depression or recession comes for entrepreneurs. This is the time for you to get mega rich. Mega rich. Some of you that I meet that are incredibly talented, go harder. You have valuable brands, valuable currency, like go harder. In every disaster, there is immense opportunity. Most people won't tell you that, but a lot of people that have become millionaires and billionaires did so in depression or recession.
We cannot freestyle our way to wealth. We must have a strategy. So when I built the recession portfolio, I had a strategy. If I'm going to somebody else's hood and hustle, I have to create a strategy. So I gotta know who the hustlers are. I gotta know who the hustlers are. I gotta know who the robbers are. I gotta know who the jackers are. I gotta know who moves like what, right? The next thing is researching. Once we see the players on the field, once we see who all on the field, now we say, okay, this what he do. This what she do. This, oh, they click up. They don't like them. The research marries the strategy.
What you gotta do is also make sure becoming successful is something you take personal. When you fail, that's something you take personal. You gotta master the art of taking the L. You're gonna lose. That's what makes you successful. All the failures you overcome, that's what makes you successful. But becoming successful is something you gotta make and take very personal. When we set our goals, we gotta make sure we achieve these. We gotta reach out to every motherfucking resource we got to accomplish what it is we set out to accomplish. You got Rosé right here. Are you gonna take advantage of that relationship with Rosé you could create right now?
And I'm gonna tell you like the OG always told me. He said, hey, you better live every day like it's your last. Cause one day, you gonna be right. Yeah.
Pop my shit. Yeah, I'm pop my shit. Nigga been having, you ain't got like that. Young nigga be hating, you ain't got like that. Pop my shit.